There's someone over there.
Yes, but it isn't Nazamil.
Well, let's go take a look anyway. Are you this kid's mom? I'm glad everyone's all right.
Are you going to kill us now?
What?
Or are you going to take my daughter away and brainwash her?
Wait, it's not like that.
Lies! I know who you are. The Blazing Sword of Dana is here to oppress us. And if we fight back, we die. I've heard it all.
No, listen.
I never should have come here. I'm leaving.
Wait, you...
Don't come any closer!
Well, that wasn't Nazamil.
Seemed like she wanted to move to Vicent, but in the end, she probably wouldn't have been able to fit in. I feel sorry for her child. Are you okay?
This isn't the first time this has happened. Let's go back to Vicent.
What was up with that woman and her daughter? And here we were worried about them.
It's all right, Law.
Even knowing how deep-rooted the conflict between Renans and Danans is, it's still difficult to accept that some people just won't listen.
Right. Putting all the blame for what happened on one person, it's irrational. It's too bad that wasn't Nazamil, but at least we know for sure now.
Yeah. Let's head back to Vicent.
Sure he's not just trying to hide from us? You've been looking a bit blue these days. Want to talk about it?
Well, you know how for the past year I've been traveling with Xion? Without settling down in any one place like the rest of you?
To seal up the mausoleums, right? That's something only you guys can do.
The reason I didn't stay in cities for long was because I wanted to avoid people.
Because everyone's either calling you a hero or a destroyer, right? That's why you exploded in Niez, isn't it?
Yeah. I wanted to protect Nazamil, but it wasn't just for her. A lot of that anger was for my own sake as well.
But what else could you do? Any way you look at it, they were in the wrong.
Even so, I should have handled it better. If I hadn't lost control and caused this whole mess, Nazamil wouldn't have run off.
Look, I get why it's bothering you. But that doesn't mean...
It's not just her, is it? I get the sense that behind all this, you're actually anxious about your future.
Alfin's future? What are you talking about?
You really are perceptive when it comes to other people.
If people could be perceptive about their own business, no one would ever have anything to worry about.
No doubt. You're right, though. I'm in this mess just handling my own problems. I worry I'm not ready.
Regardless of what anyone says, it's your life. Don't let your future slip away from you. Or perhaps I should say, your future together?
Wait, that's... you mean Alfin and Xion?
Spluttering like a fish is not proper decorum, young man.
You're not even that old!
I'll still have to think it over and choose for myself, but... I do feel better now. Thanks, guys.
How many times do I have to tell you? We cannot allow that!
What's wrong with asserting a right that I obviously have?
Not again.
Fine. If it's come to this, I'll use my astral arts to show you who your master is.
Enough!
Why, you insolent!
This man wishes to emigrate here, but is demanding preferential treatment because he's a Renan.
That's not how things are done here. Did you come here without knowing that?
Lord Dohalim! I had heard talk, of course,
but I considered the rumors too preposterous to believe. So, it's true. The Blazing Sword and the Lord are working in league with one another. What an affront to our people!
Thank you for your help. He wouldn't listen to reason.
Lately, more and more Renans and Danans are acting like that.
It's true. I'm trying to think of solutions, but it's a very delicate situation.
Oh, one other thing. Droshin from the Department for Welfare was looking for you all. He says he has something to discuss.
Alfin. It's difficult to receive such hostility from a stranger. I know I've experienced it myself, but don't worry.
Nazamil, where have you...
Be patient. Just for a little longer.
Nazamil, come back! I want to talk...
Nazamil was right here! Maybe we can... it's no good. There are too many people.
What did she mean by be patient? And why appear now of all times?
We spent so long searching for her. Was she actually watching us the whole time?
Please forgive me for summoning you all. I was hoping I could ask you to deliver a personal correspondence to Cyslodin.
A delivery? Isn't that a job for the Service Corps?
Usually, yes. Truth be told, they aren't too fond of the Corps over there as of late.
Really? The letter is for Bregan of the Silver Swords, right? I can't see him being upset about it.
He isn't the issue. It's the citizens of Cyslodin. They're not just wary of Renans, but Danans too.
Makes sense. It is Cyslodia, after all.
I see. And you've come to us because you think no one would risk interfering with us, is that it?
Yes. Of course, I don't think such a task would require all of you to carry it out.
What do you want to do? It's possible Nazamil will come back here.
Judging by that interaction, I don't think we'll see her again. Until she's ready. In which case, it's meaningless to continue searching for her. I think we should stay together so we're not apart when she returns.
But...
What Dohalim says makes sense. Besides, we've been trying to find Nazamil for a while. It would be good for you to focus on other things for a bit.
Yeah. Alright then. We'll make the trip to Cyslodin.
Thank you so much. Here is the letter.
So what's this correspondence about?
It's a formal letter between autonomous organizations.
If only we could use Renan communication equipment.
True. There are so many Renan machines we've been unable to use since Lenegas collapsed.
It's fine. I was just surprised to see him appear out of nowhere. I'm sorry for worrying you.
Shion, do you still have some of your anxieties from when you had your thorns?
Yeah, I guess. Sometimes I still panic when someone approaches me too suddenly. You know what they say about old habits dying hard.
Right. That must be difficult.
But overall, I've gotten pretty used to physical contact with others. It makes me happy more than anything.
The joy of human contact. Hearing that from you, of all people, makes it sound all the more wonderful.
Yeah, I'm with you there. And also, I think it's easy to forget as you grow older, but just the warmth of another can be really comforting. It's cold in Cyslodia, but when I hug Hoodle tight, It warms me right to the soul.
I remember how, whenever I was feeling anxious or when times were hard, my brother would silently rub my back. The warmth of his hand told me that everything was going to be all right. It was reassuring.
Yeah. It's a way of communicating without words, isn't it?
I've still only experienced that a few times, but I think I understand.
Well, for what it's worth, you're always welcome to hug me, or even just lean on me, whenever you want. You too, Rinwell.
Yeah, and the same goes for the two of you with me. You too, Hoodle. Look, Xion, Kisara's waiting for us with open arms.
Really? Now? Well, all right then. I guess it'll help me get more comfortable with this sort of thing. Thank you. Both of you.
That was quite the little adventure we went on.
It's as cold as ever here.
The sun may have come back, but this place is still in the mountains.
It will take time for the current amount of snow to melt down to this region's new normal.
Thank you.
cat. I wonder how Zari's doing.
I wasn't expecting you to come deliver a letter. Sorry for the trouble.
We heard they've been very critical of outsiders in Cyslodia of late.
Cyslodia still has almost no Renans, right?
The Renans are definitely all gone, but there's still some lingering uneasiness between the Danans here. And I keep hearing rumors about survivors of the Snake Eyes being active.
So, people will always fight, even among their own kind.
All you need for a disagreement is two people. If you want a reason, you can easily find one. Plus, this is Cyslodia. It takes time for deeply ingrained mindsets to change.
Time, huh?
Of course, there are some people trying to actively change things. Some are even inspired by what you all are doing. If you don't mind, I hope you'll have a look around town.
It's been a year since they were freed, but they seem as nervous as ever. Caution was a matter of life or death when the Renans ruled here. Learning to relax those deeply ingrained survival instincts won't happen overnight.
Looks like we get to sleep with a roof over our heads.
Still avoiding eye contact. It's like nothing's changed.
It'll take more time for them to reach that level of comfort with other people.
Hey, you there. I knew
knew I recognized you.
You're that...
Shh, not so loud.
What's wrong? The days of being monitored are long over.
Oh, come on. You didn't forget I used to be an informant, did you? Revenge and vigilante justice are officially prohibited, but still... Anyway, that's not why I'm here.
What? Is something the matter?
Yeah, a pal of mine left town and I haven't heard from him since. It's been 3 whole days.
Why not ask the Silver Swords? They should listen, regardless of your past.
You think I'd be suffering in silence if it were that easy?
Is there more to the story, then?
You ask for help, then clam up. Not exactly what I'd call trustworthy.
Please, you're the only ones I can turn to.
Maybe we should help him out.
Law?
So, this guy's really a friend of yours?
Yeah, I'm not lying.
All right, we'll search for him.
You seem strangely supportive of him, Law.
I mean, sure, he used to be an informant. But he's clearly trying to change his ways. I just want to help him with that.
I agree. In times like these, respecting someone's wish to start over seems more important than ever.
We've reached our destination.
It must be hard to still be afraid to talk to each other, even after a whole year has passed.
I guess people like us will just have to keep doing our best to help things change.
He's saying the king is calling for him. I think.
Go no further!
Don't worry, I've got plenty to go around.
Try harder!
It's time!
Gemini Hawk!
No further!
Well,
you require a hand. Not today!
Piercing
blow! No further!
Who's in a bright and shiny mood? There's something in the water.
Wouldn't it be easier to simply use astral arts to catch the fish and be done with it?
That misses the whole point of going out to fish. Per se.
Could have been worse. At least you caught something.
hope we catch something decent.
Indeed. Hungry bellies are counting on this.
Reel it in.
Well, that wasn't much of a challenge.
Not too shabby, friend.
All right, once more from the top. Reel it in. I reeled us in a big one.
That flapper was a true fighter.
She's a big un. This is quite the catch, if I do say so myself.
Look at you, fishing like a pro.
Wouldn't it be easier to simply use astral arts to catch the fish and be done with it?
That misses the whole point of going out to fish. I can't wait to start making our meal.
Ooh, we having something new to eat?
Yep, now that we have all the ingredients.
Wow, this place hasn't changed a bit. Is it just me, or does the mood here seem a bit tense?
What? You say the king and queen are arguing?
Maybe we could do something about it. It'd feel wrong to just ignore them.
You mean help them make up? Okay, but how?
Well, I don't know. We could try figuring out the reason why they're fighting. It would be a start, at least.
Right. If only we had some sort of clue as to what could have caused it.
What's that right there? It looks like some sort of nutshell. Is this what they've been fighting over?
You ate this nut without telling me?
No, I would never.
There they go again.
Ah. Deduction through reenactment. Clever.
Since this is here, someone ate it. And you and I are the only ones around. But I certainly didn't eat it. Ergo.
Neither did I. Do you mean to accuse me of nut-huggery? If I am blessed with a nut, I share it with you. No nut is sweeter than one savored with my dear.
Don't you think I feel the same? I...
How long is this gonna go on for?
I don't know. Don't ask me.
If neither of them ate the nut, isn't it possible that another owl left it behind?
Should that be the case, this spat would be an unfounded one.
Hold up. The real question is, was that reenactment even right in the first place?
Well, the mood does seem a bit lighter now. Don't you think?
Case closed, then.
Is it, though?
Let's just leave it at that.
You can never be too prepared, but did we have to spend so much?
Camping isn't so bad, as long as it's with good company.
To grow. Thank you.
Heaving Descent! Flashing Fang!
Didn't even break a sweat.
Victory nonetheless.
We have a long way yet to go.
In these temperatures, collapsing outside of town is practically a death sentence.
Yeah, I hope he's okay.
I wonder what the reason is. We're not dealing with a criminal, are we?
Right, here goes! You're the
I never
inside
miss.
Me, yours, to be let free! Strike! Eat dirt!
Raging
moon!
All the power
Try
of my glowing arc to accomplish this!
Explosive rain!
Lightning!
Thunder! Dragon force!
Illuminate the stage!
Holy glitter!
Explosive
rain!
Away! Get toasty!
Burn strike! My turn!
No further!
Orochi's Fury!
Hold on to your arm, Domomai! Here I come! Eat
soup!
This ends now!
Consider yourself finished!
That's some power you wield.
You're the one who did the heavy lifting.
What?
You
there!
Have got.
Stay calm! In a bright and shiny mood.
That's one place to put it.
You think we can take that, Zugel?
If you're gonna fight it, I'll cover you.
An opponent like this should be easy.
Glacial spear, pierce evil, far enough.
Let Astral
the wind. Flame inside me,
sweet
yours
mouth.
To be let free.
I'm gonna take that one.
Not today.
To be healed.
Flash the shot.
Arnix, for cover for now. My healing arc. That is your dream.
Lightning
descend.
Prepare to be healed. Actually, I haven't found this more appropriate.
Let's talk in your duel.
Heal
for it!
Illuminate!
Ruin!
I've healed myself.
Sealed!
Void Flash!
Shine!
Lunar Mondo!
Here I come!
Regenerate!
Rising
Phoenix!
Ready to
go! Not today!
Astral energy! Full throttle!
Go!
The flawless
victory!
Naturally!
The
Scion
is watching! Is that a healing art? It is. I can't ignore your pain. I'll try to be more careful. I still had room to grow.
There. Let's keep moving.
Wait, we should tend to your arm first.
Ah!
there?
It's a Renan, and he appears to be injured.
Thanks a lot.
Say, you don't happen to have a Danon friend, do you?
Why do you ask?
So he's the one.
I knew it. Your friend asked us to find you.
He did? That idiot. What am I supposed to do if the people in town find out?
He must have been worried about you. Can you walk? Let's go back to town together.
No. I can't go to Cyslodia. They kicked out all the Renans. I'm going back to my hideout in the mountains. Tell him thanks for me, okay?
I never would have imagined his friend's a Renan.
It's no wonder he turned to us.
I wonder what their connection is.
I'm sure he can explain more.
That doll looks just like Hoodle, doesn't it?
Hoo!
Why's your owl being sassy with me?
He says he looks way more handsome than it.
If he says so.
Come here, sweetie. There you go. Very good. Yes, that's a good boy.
Shion? What are you doing over there all by yourself?
Oh! Alvin? It's not what it looks like. This is... How much did you see?
You were waving your hand back and forth and muttering something.
What? So you were watching the whole time? How could you?
I'm sorry. Is it that upsetting?
It's a matter of privacy, Alfin. There's no excuse for peeping. But, Shion, it's nothing to be ashamed of. I've done similar things myself.
You too?
Sure. Like sometimes when I'm fishing by myself, I'll imagine I'm sharing the catch with you all.
Doesn't that mean Kisara was peeping too?
Yes, you understand. Since we were all traveling together for so long, it was easy to get used to everyone being so close.
So then when they aren't there anymore, it can make you do strange things.
I actually tried a variety of other fluffy things as a stand-in, but it just wasn't the same.
Of course, that's a different thing entirely.
What are you two talking about?
Yeah, what are you talking about?
Oh, I get it. That was practice for petting Hoot. If you like the little guy that much, why don't you just ask Rinwell if you can take care of him for a while?
That's not what we mean at all. You just don't understand.
You have a long way to go, Alfin.
What?
So, did you two want to pet Hoodle? What do you say, Hoodle? Would it be all right?
Really? All right. Here goes.
Kisara, I have been meaning to ask you. Do you find your duties leaving you overworked as of late?
How abrupt. What brought this question on?
Well, it's only that I worry you haven't been able to find the time to go fishing.
Oh, is that all? There's no need to worry. I do have other ways to relax outside of fishing. I used to fish to secure food for the day, but now that the food distribution network has stabilized, that's no longer an issue. That said, if you're ever feeling a craving for fish, don't hesitate to let me know.
That's a lovely suggestion, but it's the sight of you by the water, rod in hand, that has been etched into my mind. I find it unfortunate that, within the past year, I no longer have as many opportunities to see you enjoying yourself in the great outdoors.
Why don't you try fishing yourself, then? You might like it. In fact, I'd be happy to plan something. It'd give me a chance to introduce you to the joy of fishing. You on one side of the rod, a fish on the other. It's like a negotiation, but also the perfect time for self-reflection. Though, of course, what really keeps you coming back is the excitement of landing a big one.
I'm afraid I'll have to decline.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess I let myself get a bit carried away.
Oh, no. I can tell that fishing truly is special to you. What I mean to say is, I'd prefer to be an onlooker, relaxing at your side, and perhaps engaging in conversation from time to time.
Oh, Doe. It's settled then. I'll find the opportunity when things have calmed down.
Of course. When that time comes, I look forward to accompanying you.
Whoa, that came out perfect!
I think we've rested long enough. Let's keep moving.
Thank you.
Your blade moves like silk. I just let my instincts take over.
In an instant! Impact Claw!
Am I on a roll or what?
Well, look who's in a bright and shiny mood.
I think it's safe to rest here now. So he didn't leave town. He was never in it to begin with.
We found your friend. He made it safely back to his home.
I see. That's good to hear. Now that you've met him, you know why I had to turn to you.
And may we ask how you know each other?
When people found out I was an informant, things got nasty. I fled town, which would have been fine, but it was too cold and I collapsed.
And that's when he saved you?
At first I was suspicious, but I can tell when someone's fishy or not. And I knew he was sincere about helping me.
Why does he keep living in those snowy mountains instead of moving to one of the other realms?
He says he loves the Cyslodian mountains. Can you believe it? A year ago when the skies were clear, he said he was simply stunned. Couldn't believe how beautiful it was. He's a good guy. Interesting to talk to, and he knows a lot. In return, I get him what he needs to survive.
Sounds like a nice relationship.
I guess. Anyway, I'm gonna get moving before we draw attention. Thanks, you helped a lot. I guess people weren't joking about you being a hero.
Cyslodia looks the same as ever, but perhaps it actually has changed.
It bothers you, doesn't it? Being called a hero.
No.
Since we came all the way to Cyslodia, why not check out Calaglia too?
Calaglia? I mean, I guess it's not far from here. But what about Nazamil?
We're not going to be able to find her now. She'll come to us when she wants to. So it doesn't matter where we are.
Well, I don't mind. But what about you, Alfin?
Let's go. It's better than spinning our wheels here.
Okay. Calaglia, huh? I wonder how the Crimson Crows are doing.
Pretty much the same. Just doing a lot better these days, obviously.